My name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com, and this is your news alert for Tuesday, January 6, 2009. Let me start by clarifying that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do conduct real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account, so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. Now, there are a few economic reports scheduled for release tomorrow, which is Tuesday, and most of them have sparked enough volatility for a new scalp trade on more than one occasion last year, which is 2008. Two of those reports are based on surveys of purchasing managers at service firms in the United States and the United Kingdom. The key number from those reports is a purchasing manager index, and an index number below 50 signifies that the services sector has been shrinking in whatever respective country the report pertains to. The recent U.S. and U.K. PMI numbers have been below 50. In fact, the numbers for November were downright terrible, and the forecast for December's numbers calls for even worse, again, for both the U.S. and U.K. services sector. Now, I'm open to the possibility of some volatility among the major currency pairs in response to these reports, but I'm not generally expecting any significant reactions because I think that further shrinking of the services sectors in the U.K. and the U.S. is already priced in, or as some traders like to say, it's baked into the cake. Now, ditto that line of thinking on the U.S. pending home sales report, which is due for release at 10 a.m. New York time. I think more bad news about the U.S. housing sector is already baked into the cake. What may not be priced in is the possibility of a deep rate cuts by the European Central Bank. Now, one factor which should sway that central bank toward further monetary easing or cutting rates would be the threat of deflation. And while the Eurozone isn't there just yet, the pace of disinflation seen in the Eurozone over the past 4 months has to be keeping the ECB on higher alert right now. During tomorrow's London session, Eurostat will report a flash estimate of Euro area inflation in December. If that estimate shows further declines in Eurozone prices, it could raise the odds of another rate cut next week, and that should put downward pressure on the Euro. Now, this report does not, I repeat, does not have a history of sparking volatile moves on the Euro. It might tomorrow, but even if we don't see a big move on the Euro in response to that flash CPI estimate news, a much lower than expected flash estimate for Eurozone CPI could still set Tuesday's tone for the Euro. Good luck and good trading, everyone. My name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your news alert for Tuesday, January 6, 2009.